Welcome to the first episode of the Mac with You Fountain Pen Podcast.
最好是
哎呀 Episode 几了 huh? 我都忘记了
5 or 6 I did it
5 啦 I think 是不是 5 啊 Actually 我也不记得 随便啦 等一下再 check So, 你有看吗? 那个 event, 那个 live stream?
那天没有看呢。
做我啊? 哦,你在睡觉啊?
没有呢, in the end 在Bangkok, 他不是收得很大吗?
你在Bangkok? 你在Bangkok 那时候?
啊?
你在Bangkok?
啊,对啊。
I didn't know you were, you were in Bangkok on the day itself.
哦,是吗?
嗯,我不知道咧, 我还以为你在家咧。
哦,沒有咧,我在Bangkok咧。你在Bangkok做什麼?蛤?你在Bangkok做什麼?就去幾天走走這樣喔。哦。啊,
then 你在hotel room裡面啊。哦。切。還套為什麼沒有看?因為你在旅行。秀啊。哪裡有秀?哎呀,so what do you think?
就這樣咯。哪一個?
就这样咯,是哪一个?
电话还不错。
电话还不错哦。 电话你接得怎么样啊? 电话, 如果你问我的话, 那个电话, right? Well, the design is expected 咯, 因为之前有很多 rumors 嘛, 不是讲是完全一样的 design 咯。 But I like the fact that 它的那个 chamfer 现在是 matte 的咧。 那个你懂，它旁边不是那个 shiny shiny 那个地方啊，它现在是 matte 哦 ，matte 到完的咯，所以哦 ，I think most likely 哦，你不小心撞到它的 ding 不会很 obvious， 因为之前那个很容易 scratch 的嘛，不是咩
？True， 没有啦，不是 scratch 啊，敲到很明显哦。好咯
，I mean 你轻轻哦痛到一点，它就一个洞大大了嘞，是很 obvious 的那个 ding。
Yeah.
Yo, that's the one design element I hate the most that came from Apple. I mean, it looks nice but it can only look nice on day one.
The chamfer.
Yeah, lor, the diamond cut chamfer. Shit, the diamond cut chamfer. I don't want the diamond cut chamfer.
But that you drop your phone also.
When?
There was once you drop it at the bar.
Hey, shit lah. Where was that?
That was the chamfer.
That was the chamfer, man?
Yeah, you hit the chamfer.
No, I got it changed, right? After that.
Yeah, you got it changed.
yeah. Probably that was the chamfer, okay. I don't remember. But you know what? All the iPads 还有那个 chamfer 咯. That, I cannot stand the fact that all the iPads now still have the chamfer. 新的 iPad 也有那个 chamfer. What the fuck are they thinking of?
They probably think you won't go around knocking your iPad into something else.
But then it's a fact that 那个 double cut chamfer hor, don't know how they make it lah. Most likely 就是因为它已经 age 好那个 它已经做好那个 aluminium 之后, then 它才去 cut 那个 aluminium 嘛. 所以它的 strength 很 weak 嘛. So any single bump hor, you will ding the thing 咯.
True.
And then ha, an iPad with a lot of dings looks like shit ah. That's the one main reason I will never buy an iPad and then not protect it with a case or anything.
Usually people will use it with a case.
Usually man, not always leh. 你没有用 case 对不对?
You use a pouch?
你有用 pouch 啊, 你用 pouch 才吗?
就 OK 哇
，Porsche 是 pouch 嘞，而且你拿出来用的时候没有 case 嘛，
我又不会去敲它。
You never know 嘛，那时候我看你的 iPad 好像就已经蛮多钉了。
嗯，
不是吗
？Probably has
有啊，很多啊，很 obvious 啊，
那真多
有啦。你没有 cover 那个 chamfer 就是这样的，没有办法哦。That's a stupid thing 哦 about the iPad design。Why they leave the stupid chamfer? I mean, I thought they left the chamfer behind in since they went to the iPhone 6. But the iPad, they never change. They don't bother to change. 最新的还是一样有那个 diamond cut chamfer.
Maybe it's very hard to make it without the chamfer.
That's bullshit 咯。那刚刚那个 iPhone SE 不是给你看的那个 matte chamfer， 那个 matte chamfer 根本都不是 chamfer 来的嘞，那个就是它一开始哈，它 etch 那个 aluminium 的时候就 etch 进去了嘞，它根本没有拿那个diamond 去 cut 它的那个 chamfer 出来。
I don't know.
Yeah, so no, that is I think that is the best thing about the SE. Yes, that the chamfer is no longer diamond cut chamfer.他不是自从他 iPhone 5和 5S 做那个 diamond cut chamfer 之后 ，then all of the stupid Android manufacturer all start making it 嘛。现在哈、哦、不从哪里 all the China brands 啊 ，all the Samsungs 啊、mm-hmm. ，they are all having diamond cut chamfer on their phones，which is why 你随便去一个地方，你要看到很多钉 on 他的 phone， 那种 display unit 一大堆钉。而且 for some reason 哈、哦，那些 Android 的他们的 diamond cut chamfer 哈、哦，好像是怎么讲啊？比较 weak 的嘞 ，it's easier to scratch them 哈、哦、than the Apple ones。For some reason， 你有没有 notice 到？
嗯 ，probably the grade of aluminium they use。
No， I think the grade is the same probably。
Cannot be the.
How you know？
你不觉得 Android 的电话比较容易刮到，比较容易摔坏吗？
嗯 ，yeah, possible, possible. I mean, look at the Nexus 6P, 对不对？
嗯哼，
那个 China 啊，华为做的嘛。
Yep.
哇，老耶，那个笑的 ，all the videos online 哈、啊、，show that it can bend way easier than the original iPhone 6啊。连它的 chamfer 很容易钉哈、哦，很容易钉的嘞，很容易 scratch 啊。如果你去 Sandy Square 看它的 display unit， 你就知道了。
Probably that's because there's a difference in the metal they use.
What difference? I mean, 如果你比
就烂一点哦，
是啦。如果你比那个 6S 的那个 aluminium 跟它的华为的 aluminium 比，当然有 difference 啊。因为 6S 的 aluminium 是 Apple 自己调的嘛。
嗯哼，
它不是那个7000 series aluminium， 它自己做的 alloy 来的嘛。
Yep.
So it's way stronger lah. That one I understand lah. But then ho, oh yeah ho, that reminds me.
Mm-hmm.
SE 的那个 aluminium 是不是 7000 series 啊？
哇 ，this I don't know.
It will make
sense, highly possible 吗
？Yeah, it will make sense for them to be the 7000 series. I mean, 你看他已经调那个 7000 series 啊 ，it makes no sense for them to just keep it for the iPhone 了。
Probably uses the same metal then.
Most likely 咧，因为我有去 feel 那个 SE 咧，它 SE 的那个 aluminium 哈 ，the feel of the aluminium is closer to 我的 6S Plus 啊 ，than to 我原本的 5S.
Probably is a different grade.、
Mm, it's a different grade of aluminium. I'm pretty sure. 因为哈那个那个 SE 哈，它 aluminium 哈，你 feel 的时候，它比较它的 texture 比较 rough 的咧。Like 有点 sandblast 的感觉哦 ，and then it's almost the same as the 6S Plus 的 feel compared to 你的 5S 我的 5S 的那个 gold 的 aluminium 哈、哦，你摸哈、哦嗯、就是很滑咯 ，it's like 以前的 aluminium 哦这样。
That makes sense.
嗯，对咯。Okay. So other than the chamfer, okay 啦 ，then 就 A9 咯 A9.And then, 还有什么 ？12 megapixel 的那个
图，很多人他就长得一模一样。
对咯，长得一模一样。Which is why, huh? If you ask me, 如果你要买一个 SE, huh? There's only one color you should buy, which is the rose gold.
If not, you won't be able to differentiate.
Yeah, you won't be able to differentiate the difference. You can't tell the difference, with your 5S.
除非看后面咯 ，there's the SE there.
哇，然后怎么看？看不到的。这样浅那个字那个 SE
又这样小，
对咯，看不到的啦，没有可能看得到。
So get a rose gold one 咯。
嗯 ，everywhere you go, right? The display units are all rose gold 咯。So,
Because
嗯
，that's the only new thing.
That's the only new thing 啊。
There's actually visible 啦 ，actually there's a lot of unseen changes.
Oh, but I went around certain telco 的certain telco 的那些店哈。 蛮多地方他们 run out 的 OK 64 rose gold that one is expected they are out of stock for 64 rose gold
SE?
Yeah SE
有人买啊
有 you'd be surprised
嗯
as in 没有人去排队啦 but 有人买 but 另外一台 run out 的是什么你知道吗
什么
Space Gray 64 也是 out of stock And the last I checked, right, M1 the website 已经没有 64GB 的 Space Gray 了.
I would expect Singaporean to don't give a shit.
But 要买的人还是会买嘛, 对不对?
就很多人都会觉得是, like, why is it going backwards?
It's not going backwards, eh. I mean, spec-wise, it is brand new specs, ma. But price-wise, it's way cheaper than the 6S.
But 8 out of 10 iPhone user bone.
Yeah, 8 out of 10, yeah. Like,
don't even know what's inside.
Like you and me, 我们买最新的电话, 所以没有, it's impossible for us to even consider the SE. Ma. But yeah. There are people who want the SE. Like 我的 brother 一直讲, 那个, even the 6 that he's using now is too big, for his pocket. Too big for his pocket.
True.
Hmm. Then he wear jeans 嘛 Then 有时候 那个 six 他放进去 jeans pocket 他的头已经 凸出来了 The top of the phone yeah.
It does lah
Yeah so it's quite uncomfortable 咯 So I think You know There are people Who want to buy the SE 咯
But I don't think 会很多
不会很多 lah But yeah. 要买的人还是会买的 lah
Is it enough to get the telco out of stock?
Yeah, I mean, you probably think if it's enough to get the telco on certain models out of stock, it's probably doing a better job than the S7, right?
Probably,
the Galaxy S7.
Definitely, what?
The S7 没有 out of stock. I go around asking, nobody has any S7s out of stock.
In the first place, Samsung 做电话的时候不是很像生出来这样
What do you mean by 生出来?
But they have no problem making tons and tons of it.
Really, meh? I think they just probably have too much supply, no?
Yeah.
That demand 本来就不是很高, ma. Meh, 要买的人还是会买, la. It's the same thing, la. 要买的人还是会买, la. It's just not like the usual iPhone, 每个人 key sell, go online, whack 那个 website, 去 order.
True.
Hmm. To the fact that 你有钱 你都不可以买到你要的那个 model. Yeah, 就这样咯, SE. Oh, but you know the specs 它里面不是有一个 A9 then 有一个 12 megapixel 的那个 camera 咯 but yeah. cannot stand the fact that 它前面的 camera 是那个 1.2 的咧
Oh, it's not the 5.
It's not 5 leh. 要换就换到完嘛. 你干嘛留那个 1.2 在那边 leh? 蛮 irritating leh. And then don't forget the fact that huh, the majority of people who might buy the SE are girls. Huh? And then girls are going to use the front camera. Leh. And then 你给他一个烂的 front camera. Just the front camera alone can put a lot of people off from buying it.
Hmm, but There's, maybe because 它还是很多
它也是很多的那什么 那个 front screen panel 是不是
Yeah
它 panel confirm 是拿 5S 的咯 那个很 obvious 的嘛
可是它连那个 camera 都懒得换的
唉 就那个 module 才咯 干嘛不会换那个 module 呢 会死是不是 真的是哦 Sometimes you think what the F are they doing
就赚钱吗
没有想的咯 它换那个小小个的东西 It can probably increase their marketing by 100 times 耶 Then it will truly be a 6S in a 5S body. 就是因为它没有那个前面的那个 camera, 它不是 6S in 5S body. 它就差那个东西才.
True.
所以 if you ask me, if people ask me whether they should buy the SE, I always have to go through the fact that I have to tell them, are you willing to live with the 那个 1.2 megapixel the front camera if you are then it's okay
I think to a lot of people it's a turn off
yeah of course 就这样咯 price wise price is quite expensive as in the phones are quite expensive
in Singapore it's quite expensive
it's quite expensive in Singapore and around the world because for some reason Apple 的 the official exchange rate that they are using right now is very, very high, even though USD has dropped a little bit since then. 你懂 for Singapore 他们用多少吗?
多少?
1.7 勒。
1.7?
嗯。 现在哦, Singapore dollar to US dollar 是 1.3 多才 勒。 他们用 1.7 你知道吗?
为什么是
1.7? 因为我问谁, 问 Apple 啊。 你去算哦, 1.7 勒。
US 什么时候涨过 1.7 的?
对咯, 没有, 他们是, 他们每次都是放一个比较高一点的嘛。 To, you know, just in case USD 突然间起很高, then 他们 lugi 嘛。
Ridiculous.
嗯, but 现在他们起到 1.7, 他们用 1.7 的 exchange rate 哦。 How much are they going to earn? They're going to lose a lot of sales just by the fact that 他们的 products 哦, are way more expensive than competing Android products 哦。 Just because of the USD 呢? Despite the fact that 他们的 devices are all made in China. Assembled in China. Technically speaking.
Assembled are not made.
Yeah, of course not made. 里面的 component 大多数都不是 China.
Oh well. 你还是会去买 what?
买什么? SE?
No, SE. People still will go and buy it.
Yeah, lah, yeah lah. I mean, the assembled in China thing is not a big deal. Lah, of course. No, the issue here is too expensive. Oh. The exchange rate, they should turn down, they should tune down the exchange rate. Oh. 不可以咯, 1.7 有点过分哦, 你 1.5 还可以, 可以讲过去哦, 你 1.7 勒, 1.7 勒, 神经病啊, 因为你是谁?
Apple.
哎呀, oh.
So,
what's next? iPad 咯?
Pro Mini.
Ah, what do you think about it?
Actually, what's the official name?
Pro lor.
It's just Pro 9.7.
Mm, Pro 9.7 lor.
他死都不要叫 Pro Mini 的, cause it's not
难听吗? 他有一个 Mini, 他不可能放一个 Pro Mini 嘛, 这样
It's really a miniature. Okay, not really.
It's not lor. It's not lor.
But to a lot of people, it is. Right?
To stupid people, it is lah.
True.
It's not much of a Pro if you ask me.
iPad Air 3 with Apple Pencil support.
Hmm, that should be the correct naming. Okay, if you ask me, right, there are a few reasons why they this particular iPad is the iPad Pro 9.7 instead of the iPad Air 3. One thing, 他们要 increase 它的 price.
对啊，跟你讲 Pro 就可以卖比较贵嘛。对
，correct。 Partly, probably because they also want to 把那个 storage 的那个 capacity 换成 32, 128和 256, and then the associated cost increase. Oh, they must find, you know, something to justify it. So instead of the Air 3, Air 3 的话, you assume the Air 3 就跟去年的 Air 2 一样嘛, then 它的 starting price 应该 499嘛, 对不对?
Yeah,
but 如果他要起 如果他的 cost 起, so 他要 push 他的 price 起, 所以他不可以是同样的 product, 他不可以是同样的 product line 嘛, so 他就 invent 一个 product line 咯, 就 Pro 9.7 咯。 But when you look at the innards, there's not a lot of things that is very pro about it. 他不是讲 what do you think, how do you think a Pro is a Pro 呢? iPad Pro is a Pro 呢? 如果我问你的话,
iPad Pro is a Pro.
Like,
in what sense?
就是说我就问你, where is the Pro? Like, 如果你现在看到那个 12.9寸的那个 the real iPad Pro, 对不对? Okay, which features of the iPad Pro do you consider Pro?
Speed.
Really, meh?
Screen.
The screen size, ah?
Resolution.
Okay, one thing. Then, then.
电话不要再响了。我很多字。
Then
what else? 哎呦，你现在问我那想个大。我那就是问你咯。是它的 screen 咯。Screen
才咩 ？Screen enough 啊。
Screen speed.
嗯。
What else?
I have Apple Pencil support.
Yeah lah.
Okay, 如果你问我, okay, I justify by the fact that iPad Pro, 它的 interface, 它的 UI 不同嘛, 对不对? 因为它的 resolution 不同, so when you install iPad apps that are optimized for the iPad Pro, 它的 UI 不同的咧。
Mm-hmm, yep.
The way it looks, the way it functions is different from if you run the same app on the normal iPad Air 2. So the difference in resolution, which results in a different UI, is one of the pro features. And second feature, is 4GB RAM. The current generation, the iOS devices, 全部 2GB 才来, 只有 iPad Pro 是 4GB.
Okay.
Okay. And then thirdly, of course, the Apple Pencil, the support. But this iPad Pro 9.7 inch, firstly, 它的那个 RAM 才 2GB.
就跟 iPad Pro 一样, 不,
iPad Air 2.
Yeah, iPad Air 2 一样.
iPad Air 2 是 2GB, 哈?
对啊。
对对对, 2GB, correct.
2GB.
Then, 它, okay 啦, 它有 Apple, 它有 Apple Pencil support 啦, that's one thing. Then next thing 就是 它的 resolution 跟 iPad Air 都一样, so you don't get a different UI at all. You don't get a different resolution, you don't get a different UI. You don't get a full screen, full size keyboard.
它就几条跟 because of the screen size 嘛, 不是吗? You see, by right they can do it in a sense 它 shrink 那个 resolution.
可以啊, technically speaking, like how the iPad mini is done, they can shrink the iPad Pro, the 那个 resolution down to 9.7 the size ma. And then have everything smaller lah, that's one thing. Although the keyboard might not be good lah, if it's so small.
But because of the screen size of 9.7, 它可能不要这样做.
它可能不要这样做, or 它 can't be bothered to do this kind of thing.
Yeah.
I don't know which one it is lah, but to me ha, 你看, the features that they tout as very pro for the 9.7, like, okay, 4 speakers, okay lor, 4 speakers, or so be it, extra 2 speakers. And next thing 就是, Apple Pencil supports Apple Pencil support lah. That's a good thing. And then, A9X. A9X, don't you think so? 你看, 它, Apple 的 chip, 它每年都会 become faster 的嘛。
Yep.
去年 A8X, 今年 A9X. It's just obvious, what? 你不可以跟我讲, just because 明年 是 A10X, 它就有一个 new product line 叫 iPad Ultimate 出来吧。 你每年 eventually 还是要, you know, make strides, make improvement in your, you need to have improvement in your performance, in your chip, 不然没有人要买嘛, 对不对? So 你今年 A9X in your iPad Pro, of course your even if you're coming out with a iPad Air 3, it's going to be the A9X ma. So the A9X in itself is going to be A9X. 不管怎么样, you cannot justify just because you put the A9X in the new 9.7 inch iPad, you are going to call it a Pro. Or you are going to increase the price.
True.
Then, what else? 那个 True Tone Screen Technology. Come on, 那个 True Tone, you know the True Tone Screen Technology thing, right? It's basically just auto night shift, 嘛. Basically, 它就是里面有几个 sensor, 它可以看你的, 它可以 sense 到你的 room 里面的 color temperature. Then 它只是调那个 color temperature to suit the color temperature in your room. That's all only. It's not a big deal. It's a software function that requires probably a little bit of what do you call
coding.
It? No, not coding. They have to put some sensors that can tell color temperature. But then 那个 sensor 最多几毛钱才, whatever sensor it uses is probably the same sensors that like have long existed in digital cameras that can tell color balance.
But then again, they are again the first
one to make it inside a tablet lah. Yes lah.
Hello?
So eventually, other people will start copying.
You start seeing it everywhere.
Yeah. Which means probably later this year, when the iPad Pro 12.9 inch gets updated, they also have the same thing. Most likely, the next iPhone will also have the same technology, whatever. Basically, they just found a new part, and then they put it inside the iPad Pro 9.7 inch to call it a Pro feature. It's not much. It's not really very Pro, if you ask me. And then the camera is the worst. The camera, okay, yes, there, you can put 你的 6S 的那个 camera 进去里面, but now your iPad got the camera bump. And then how many people use the iPad to take photos?
What?
How many people use the iPad to take photos?
None.
真的有人买的 meh? I mean, you can put it as a feature point la, to, you know, chalk up the fact that, oh, 你看我现在 9.7 inch 的 Pro 有这样多 features, 这个 feature, and it's more features than 我之前的 iPad Pro. So, buy it. So, you have to buy it. But, when you are just adding feature for the sake of adding features, right?
You're not just practical.
You're just like Samsung. They are just adding features for the sake of adding features. If you have to learn more to adding features for the sake of adding features, you are out of it. No? It's not say not practical, they can add lah, of course. I mean, for the, since you're already paying 599 USD for a 32 gig at the 9.7 inch Pro, it must be justifiable lah to them. I mean, 因为去年你买那个,
by having more functions, more features.
Yeah, exactly. They need to have more features to justify increase in price. Which means they are just throwing in features into the new iPad to make it, you know.
So them, it's very simple, man. Just throwing existing things.
Yeah. See, existing components into something else.
Yeah, lor.
Hmm.
Which make very good sense for them.
Hmm. If you ask me, right, the iPad Pro 9.7 inch, the prices of all three options, all the 32 gig, the 108 gig, and 256 gig, has reached a point that is so high that it's not worth buying at all. No? 如果 if let's say, if I need a 9.7 inch iPad today, 现在我要买一个的话, 我会去买 Air 2, 因为 Air 2 现在 discount.
对,比较划算.
And Air 2, the performance is going to be probably about 90%, 90 to 95% of what the 9.7 inch iPad Pro can achieve. I mean, 你可以 run benchmark, then 你可以说, 你的 Pro has way more performance than the Air 2. But the fact is that iOS is never going to require so much performance. You cannot tell the difference. Air 2 已经很快, as you know, right? You have Air 2, right?
Yep.
Mm. Because Air 2 X, Air 2 the A8 X, 对不对?
对。是
not, 是什么? 是 triple core, eh?
Triple?
Do you know? It's a triple core chip, eh?
Triple, me?
它有三个 core. 所以它的 multi,
why is it odd number?
Yeah, I don't know why. It's something they did to the A8 to make it very, very powerful. A9X, 只是多 core 才. So, technically speaking, the multi-core benchmark performance of the Air 2, of the A8X, is almost equivalent to the multi-core performance of the 9.7 inch Pro. Almost 差不了多少 leh. So single
core probably because, but probably because A9X, right? 它少了一个 core. It will affect the battery performance.
不会吧? I don't think so. I don't think the battery.
我觉得会咧，因为 iPad Air 2 它的电很快完咧.
iPad
maybe 5 hours, 7 hours.
没有这样快吧?
Continuous user.
I don't have a 9.7 inch, but I bet it's going to be similar, if you ask me. Cause if you 你的 clock speed 比较快的话, of course it's going to run faster 嘛, then 你吃电也比较多嘛. And then the clock speed for the A9X is higher than the A8X, if I'm not wrong.
True, 因为它两个 clock 一定要快一点.
It's not because of that, I think it's just the base clock speed that it's running at 咯. 2.2嘛, gigahertz. No, I don't think the battery is going to be a problem. I mean, in the first place, right, nowadays, or iPad 的那个 battery life, is no longer as good as before. Because they keep putting in slimmer and slimmer batteries.
Yeah.
And then, the fact is that, they can tell it's 10 hours, but then, 它的那个 10 hour 的那个 definition, 越来越, what do you call that, skewed. So in real life, it's almost impossible to get 10 hours nowadays. You cannot be, unless you're using your tablet to watch 10 hours of video, then yes, you can get 10 hours.
Yeah. If it requires something to process.
Mm. If you're using, if you're surfing, you're doing work, you're doing a lot of multi.
很快,
对哦, 一下子就死掉了。
对。
It's not going to be 10 hours, it's going to be slightly lesser than 10 hours.
Yeah.
Mm. So,
yeah, but it's so slim, what can you get out of it?
I don't know. But if you ask me, the battery life is like that. It's going to be like that. There won't be a lot of change. I mean, 你不会, you won't get more battery life out of the 9.7 inch Pro. If that's the thing you are hoping for.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, lor.
Actually, one thing very irritating is that all the technology are advancing except battery technology.
Battery technology 就是这样的嘛. I mean, it's not like they are not advancing. It's just that the power requirements are advancing way faster than your battery technology. Lor.
No, in a sense, like there are no new technologies for battery. It's just getting bigger, that's all.
Yeah. I know what you mean. As in the new material, right?
Yeah, there are no new technological advancement. 它只是加大、加长、加厚.
So far, 现在, 全部都是 run on lithium, polymer. Lithium ion, lithium polymer, lithium, all based on lithium, right?
Yeah.
Mm.
It has been lithium for don't know how many years.
Unless 你以后有 fuel cells, oh. But it's going to be dangerous.
Become a living bomb. Yeah. But actually now, lithium is almost like a living bomb.
Yeah, it is. It is.
Yeah,
eventually, maybe something will change, but until then, we are stuck with this battery thing.
Yeah.
Can't be helped. I mean, it's a trade-off, you see. You can have heavier devices and longer battery life. Or you can have lighter devices and shorter battery life. Either way, it's a trade-off. Depends on what you want to do.
Yeah, that's quite true.
But if you ask me if you should buy the 9.7-inch iPad Pro or not, my answer is, if you have an iPad Air 2, you probably shouldn't buy one. But if your current iPad is an iPad... Air 2, right? Okay. If your current iPad is an iPad iPad 2, iPad 3, iPad 4, yeah, definitely you should buy one. Although, technically speaking,
you should get an iPad.
You can get an iPad Air 2, right?
Yeah.
It's a better deal.
No, 除非你很严那支 Apple Pencil.
对, correct. 如果你一定要用那个 Apple Pencil的话,
yeah.
Then probably you should consider the iPad Pro 13-inch.
就, maybe some people... 嫌太大太贵, 就去那个咯.
But 9.7-inch 的 iPad Pro 很小嘞. It's a very very small screen for you to draw anything.
Yeah, for a Pro, right? As in for Apple Pencil, yeah.
It's probably not good enough. I mean, you can buy that now, but most likely down the road, you'll think, I want to buy the bigger one next time. If you're really using the thing to draw, unless of course 你是拿来玩, then fine, or by all means you get the smaller Pro lah.
Yeah. No, as in, I think 会买那个小的, probably they won't use it for some hardcore thing. If you're a designer, if you are an animator, you will probably straight away get the bigger one.
If you have money, that is. I mean, there are people who are cheapskate. And
no lah, but 如果你是靠那个吃饭的，你会去买最大的吗？那个靠那个吃饭，你的
first place 你很早就买了，you don't even need to look at this 9.7 inch. 你那个12.9的时候出的时候你就已经买了。That's not even a what you call it a choice for you. If you need it, you have bought it already. 你不需要再看这个 9.7 的。 9.7 are for people who are still on the fence on whether they want to get it or not. Because if you get it and you get an Apple Pencil, the bill is going to be quite high. You know?
Yeah.
Firstly, nobody's going to get 32 gig. Right? Okay, if you are going to get 32 gig, I'm fine enough. It's going to be like $800, almost $900 plus another $200 for the Apple Pencil. So it's a big it's a big expense. Eventually, people, you know, it's something they have to consider. If you're just looking for an iPad, you don't want to buy a pencil, then by all means, get a Air 2. If you want to use the pencil, then get the Pro, the small Pro. Okay, but don't get the small Pro if you're thinking of getting, if you just want to use the smart keyboard, or if you think that the speakers are better. It's probably not worth the difference in price, if you ask me.
Speaking of which, they came out with the smart keyboard, so-called smart, for the 9.7 also, right?
Yeah, of course. Because they had they have the what you call it? The smart connector, the 3-pin connector.
Thing.
Yeah. But it's a lousy keyboard. If you want to, you know, try typing on a smart keyboard. I heard from my friend that the new box in where? In Tampines or somewhere has a display set for the smart keyboard, so you can try the keyboard. But if you ask me, it's not worth the $200 they are asking for it. I mean, there are a lot of Bluetooth keyboards that cost like $50 to $100 that are lighter, that are nicer to use than the stupid smart keyboard. It's not a very, very good accessory. I mean, I have an iPad Pro. I'm not buying the smart keyboard in the near future. Unless I strike lottery, I also don't want to buy. Yeah.
Your key to go, so man.
Keys to go, yeah, that's very good thing. It's very, very light. It's a very good Bluetooth keyboard. The battery.
Yeah, in no way affiliated with Logitech.
I don't like Logitech much, no, technically speaking. But the keys to go is quite good. It's quite light. Quite nice.
又可以卷又防水.
卷，谁跟你讲可以卷的？可以啦.
卷什么？ 就 it's bendable.
It's not bendable, leh. Whoever told you it's bendable.
It's flexible.
It's not flexible. It's hard.
It's quite lah.
No.
Just to a certain degree, 你可以拿来. Am I using the correct word? It's like flimsy.
It's flimsy, yes, but you cannot bend it. If you bend it, it will break.
Yeah lah, not bend, but as in you compare to 那种 like mine.
It's something like yours or just thinner only. I'm pretty sure if I drop my keys to go, it will break.
It won't break so easily, lah.
Hey, you'll be surprised. I'm flimsy. The whole damn thing is very flimsy. The only good thing about it is that it's very light.
Really, man?
Yeah.
Okay, then again, it might not be so good.
You have handled one before, right?
I handled a test set.
Test set from where?
Sim Lim Square. I went to choose.
And then?
Yeah, I went to play around. Just
oh well. Okay, so the conclusion is buy the 9.7 inch Pro if you want to buy a rose gold iPad or if you want to use the Apple Pencil. If not, probably not a good idea to buy it.
The best thing now is the Air 2.
Best thing? No lah. Not really best thing lah. But it's a good deal lah. If you ask me. I mean future
the best choice lah. Rather than
future
say the best
proof
thing,
wise ah, it's going to be the 9.7 inch Pro. But if you ask me, right, I think I'll wait.
Yeah, I would rather skip One generation.
Yeah, skip the first generation of the 9.7-inch Pro. Maybe the next generation of 9.7-inch Pro, they will get a 4GB RAM upgrade. So that might be better.
Yeah, so the current best choice should still be the Air 2.
Nah, it should be the 12.9-inch iPad Pro.
That is if you strike lottery.
Why lah? It doesn't cost that much. It doesn't It doesn't cost that much more than the 9.7-inch Pro.
True.
Yeah, I like my iPad Pro. It's very nice.
Okay lor.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So, oh yeah. Eventually, we didn't do the two episodes per month thing.
Actually, I think I must set a schedule. You know?
Yeah, that's what you always say. But eventually, 也是在那边 delay, 然后就 delay, 然后就 delay 的，对不对？
没有啦，其实我每次是讲好了 ，like 明天还是 下个星期这样。 We should have like set schedule.
But you know, sometimes things happen.
就 worst come to worst, like the next day after the scheduled date. So that we can have a time frame. Okay. 要不然就每次只是 like next week. 然后 it will forever be next week.
Okay, let's talk about it offline.
Okay.
But until then, we will still officially we will still follow the 1 month once schedule until something has been confirmed.
Yeah, as of now.
Yeah. Okay, lah. So I see you in early May.
Early May? Why?
No meh? Or late April lo?
Okay lo.
Today April yeah.
Oh yeah, okay lo.
Okay. Bye bye.
Bye bye.